What is that? Well, I mean, I know what it is, but what's it doing here?
Yes, it's not the best I could bring you, to be honest with you. I apologise. And I may have said something that we're going to regret, because I promised that we're going to turn this into a Nissan Skyline.
What? Are you serious? I mean, I don't often say this, but that seems impossible.
Look, the guy is lovely. He's called Harlen. He's a mature student. He's gone back into higher education. Every single penny he'd saved for his dream car, a Nissan Skyline, he's gone and invested that money in himself.
Tell me there's a massive bundle of cash that comes along with this.
There is some cash to come with it. I've got £200.
My goodness.
This old wooden steering wheel doesn't suit our track day style. I spent £60 on a black motorsport-inspired upgrade, trimmed in Alcantara for extra grip in the corners.
So, I'm going to change this steering wheel, and the first thing I'm going to do is, having taken the horn button out, I can now get access to the central nut that's in here. And I'm going to loosen that off, but not completely off, because when I start to pull this steering wheel off the splines, quite often they're pretty well stuck and you've got to give them a good yank, and eventually at some point it just dislodges and comes off, and I have hit myself in the face with these before. So now I never take the nut completely off until it's been dislodged on the splines. So give it a good wiggle, a bit of tapping. There we go. Save myself a broken nose. So I've gone for a slightly motorsport-inspired steering wheel here, because everything else around this car is pretty much in that vein. The yellow stripe here on the top of the steering wheel is just so that if you are racing this thing round a track and you've got handfuls of opposite lock, you've got a very quick visual reference as to where the top dead centre of your steering wheel is, halfway through a corner. It's quite a useful thing to have. All right, Dave. And there we go, that's that job done.
Colour coding the details of this car will give it a stronger look in any ad. So the roof's going black to match the wheels and spoiler.
The secret of good paintwork's always all about the preparation. So I'm just keying up the surface with a little bit of rubbing compound and a bit of abrasive cloth, just to give it a kind of roughed up surface for the paint to key to.
I'm keeping the spend small. These rattle cans of satin paint are just £10 each.
The trick is to not go over the same bit too much, because otherwise it builds up and you get runs. So it's a case of doing lots of light coats.
Well, it's already looking loads better.
Next, I advertised it on a website for track day fans, and Kathy gave me a call.
This is the little car.
She's come down to see it with her friend Amy.
It doesn't strike me as the kind of car that you would buy, though, Kathy. Is it for you?
No, we're actually looking at it for a friend's son.
Are you?
Yeah.
First car?
First car, track car type thing.
Perfect. I mean, what a great little thing to come play on the track with. You like it, do you, Amy?
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah. Advertised it for £500. Interested?
I was thinking more of the region of about £350.
I can't let it go for £350. Let's be nice, shall we? I'll let it go for £400.
Yeah, I could go to four.
Just bought yourself a nice car. Well done you, Amy. Top job.
I'm pleased to get that sound, but there's still a tiny amount to trade up from. I need to find a vehicle I can buy with our £3,000, add value, and then sell on for a profit.
A guy called Dylan has a Japanese import R33 Skyline he bought at auction in Japan. It's all UK legal, and he's asking £7,500 for it. Over the years, I've learned a lot of people can advertise their cars way over their actual value. So I called him and I said, would you be prepared to negotiate? And guess what? He said yes.
That's lovely. Dylan.
Hey, mate.
Very nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
How are you?
I'm good, thanks.
Yeah, excellent. What a great looking car. Sounded lovely as well as you come around the corner. Let me just turn it off. It's ticking over nicely, isn't it?
Yeah, it drives smooth, drives very well.
Yeah, it's nice. I like the big boot spoiler on the rear. The four lights looks good. Now, you said you got the auction report. Is this the paperwork here?
Yeah, I've got it in the bag.
The interior looks good.
Yeah.
Looks nice, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's
all good. Holes in the dashboard, all nice, straight, clean and tidy.
Yeah, everything works as well. All the windows, electronics.
Nice.
Which one is it?
Let me just pop it out for you. It's this one here.
Lovely. Now, I bought a few cars from Japanese auctions and it's really fun thing to do. And I can see this one's an RA, which means it's had a little bit of minor body damage in the past. But clearly, wherever that was, it's been done well. Aha! Look at that, it's got a strut brace.
Yeah, it's got the strut brace, it's got the air cone filter, it's RB25 DET, so 2.5 turbo.
It's good. Well, listen, I like it. Any chance I can go and feel what it's like out on the road?
Yeah, of course. Go for it.
Although it's only got one single turbo in this car, it's still got some mighty power. It really has, and it delivers it beautifully. I like it. I do. I like it. It's very good. Inside here, the cockpit, it's not a bad place to be at all. Very simple, nicely laid out as well. Everything seems to be functional and everything is working, which is really nice. Even got air conditioning. If I can go back and get it for $7,000, then I think I've just found Harlan his dream car.
How'd it go?
Yeah, good. Nice car. It's fast, it's smooth. I love the suspension. It's got good grip. The engine's got good power. I'd like to buy it. You want how much?
So it's up for $7,500.
The most I can stretch to is $7,000.
Right, okay.
Do you reckon you could do that?
$7,000.
I can pay you right now in cash.
Okay, yeah, let's do it. Let's go ahead and do it.
Thank you very much.
No problem.
What a top guy. Lovely, yeah, thank you very much. I like that deal.
Right, we're off to meet Harlan, and Elvis is behind the wheel. The destination is London for an early evening high-performance car event.
It's good, isn't it, eh? Look at that face of yours, eh? I've never seen you so happy.
My goodness, it's lots of poke.
It has, hasn't it? And I love all the noises it makes, the gulps, the pops, the whistles. These are a fantastic car and highly collectible.
Yeah, yeah. Well, if he's grown up anything like me, loving video games and anything Japanese, he's going to fall in love with this immediately.
Yeah, of course he is. Whoa!
I've arranged to meet Harlan in the car park where he's checking out the metal. He doesn't know that the next car rolling in will be his.
Hello, Mike.
Harlan, how are you?
Oh, I'm very well. How are you, mate?
Excellent. Yeah, I'm very good. I thought if there's supercars in the car park, you'll be hanging around them.
I know how to sniff them out.
So, you know, I asked you here for a reason. You excited?
Very excited.
Are you?
My heart's been like this all day.
Has it really?
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, my heart's been like this for weeks because I've been working, and Elvis has been working so hard to try and get what you want. And Elvis is going to come and join us right now in something I hope you'll be delighted with.
No way.
Because Harlan, this is your dream car.
Oh, my God.
Oh, you're shaking. Oh, don't have a heart attack on me, whatever you do.
Are you joking right
now?
No,
I'm not joking. And this is Elvis.
How you doing, mate?
Hello, Elvis. How are you, mate? Oh, my God, dude.
What do you think?
Yeah.
It's an R33.
This is your Nissan Skyline. You wanted a 33, and we got you a 33.
Can't believe it, mate.
Well, what was it, then, about this particular one that you love so much?
It's the rear end.
Really?
Yeah.
Come and have a look at it. Is that the rear end you were looking for?
I'll tell you, I look at this, and it takes me back to when I was a little kid, sat on my computer, playing my video games. It just takes me back. It just takes me back. And it's something that I have wanted for so long.